Welcome to War India News Hour. India wearables market reports record growth in 3Q21. India's wearables market grew by 93.8% year-on-year in third quarter of 2021, shipping 23.8 million units as per IDC. Despite the logistic challenges and increase in freight costs, vendors remained aggressive in their shipments and were able to manage the inventory for the upcoming month-long festival sales. Shipments in September surpassed 10 million, growing twofold from the same month last year, resulting in a record quarter for wearable devices in India. Watches continue to be the fastest growing category with 4.3 million shipments in 3Q21, while wristbands saw a seventh consecutive quarter of annual decline. Overall, wristwear crossed the 5 million shipments mark in a single quarter, further reinforcing the acceptance of watches in the country. Truly wireless devices reached a 39.5% share of earwear in 3Q21, but the market remains dominated by over-the-ear and tethered devices. India-based brands have captured over two-thirds of the watch market with their aggressive offerings and marketing spends on digital platforms. Noice maintained its lead for the sixth straight quarter with a 26% market share in 3Q21. Experts said, while seasonality made 3Q21 the biggest quarter for wearables, the influx of devices at the entry level was the key growth factor. Throughout the quarter, Indian vendors were aggressive with their launches and channel expansion. Aggressive intent to maintain their lead helped them to further reduce the average selling price of watches to $73, putting immense pressure on the struggling wristband category. The report further states, so far, these new age brands have been able to limit the incumbent smartphone brands' ability to make any dent in their growth and continue to dominate the hearables and wristwear categories. Secondly, celebrity endorsements are a key tactic for brand recall. However, to maintain the growth momentum, they must invest more in newer designs and aesthetics as well as newer collaboration with existing franchises. This can help create unique product experiences that will not only help associate with new customers but can also open new avenues to sell these products. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. US banks to report cybersecurity incidents within 36 hours. US regulators have approved a new rule that requires banks to report any significant computer security incident within 36 hours of discovering it. Under the rule, banks must inform their primary federal regulator about incidents that have or are reasonably likely to materially affect the viability of their operations, their ability to deliver products and services, or the stability of the US financial sector. Banks must also notify customers as soon as possible if the incident has or is reasonably likely to materially affect their users for 4 or more hours. Banks have to be compliant with the rule, which has been approved by the Federal Reserve FDIC and OCC by 1 May 2022. Companies to fully move their infrastructure to the cloud. According to a survey conducted on cloud adoption, more than 51% of all respondents said that 100% of their applicable infrastructure now resides in the cloud, while 49% said they plan to move more of their workloads into the cloud as possible. More than two-thirds of the respondents' compute workloads are now supported by public cloud, colocation and managed hosting services. At the same time, IT infrastructure spread has reached an equilibrium and leaders expect it to hold steady over the next 3 to 5 years. A vast majority of respondents agree that cloud services enable greater innovation across all aspects of the enterprise. Ford partners with GlobalFoundries to increase chip production. Ford announced on Thursday that it has entered a partnership with GlobalFoundries to develop more computer chips amid a semiconductor shortage. Officials said the tie-up could eventually result in new chip designs specifically for Ford and an increase in the domestic production and supply of chips for the overall automotive industry. Ford CEO Jim Farley said, "This agreement is just the beginning and a key part of our plan to vertically integrate key technologies and capabilities that will differentiate Ford far into the future." Flipkart enters health segment by acquiring stakes in Sasta Sundar. Flipkart Health Private Limited, a newly created entity within the Flipkart Group, has agreed to acquire a majority stake in online pharmacy and digital health platform Sasta Sundar Marketplace Limited that owns and operates sastasundar.com. The new entity will start by offering e-pharmacy services and add new healthcare verticals such as e-diagnostics and e-consultation. Sastasundar.com currently offers a digital healthcare and pharmacy platform and has a network of 490 pharmacies. Android malware Brasking returns as a stealthier banking trojan. The Android banking trojan Brasking has returned with dynamic banking overlays and a new implementation trick that allows it to operate without seeking potentially dangerous permissions. A new malware sample was analyzed by IBM Trustee researchers who found it outside the Play Store on sites where people end up after receiving smishing messages. These HTTPS sites warn the prospective victim that they are using an outdated Android version and offer an APK that will allegedly update them to the latest version. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. You can download the War India app from Google Play Store and Apple App Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.